So you've seen me mention a few times about semi-automating your trading, and the advantage of that being that you can focus on the market, and BetAngel can fill in the order entry and order exit process for you. So we're looking at a market at Kempton here. They're loading at the moment. There's a few horses still out. So what you can do is you can focus on which runner you're particularly interested in within this market. Use whatever analysis you like. And because I'm using a servant here, this means that that can manage the entry and exit. I don't even need to click specifically at where I want to enter or exit. I can just click somewhere to say, right, it's the second favorite here, Regicide, that I want to be active on. BetAngel will put the bet in for me. Now you see here it's backed at 5.5. Wait for this to get matched. But you can see the price ticked out to 5.5. Whereas because I backed first, I wanted the price to come in, so it's just put the order back in on the other side. This is a really simple servant, but the advantage of the way that this servant is working and behaving is that you focus on the trade and the servant will focus on the execution for you, whether that be entry or exit. Or as you can see here, it's just done both for us. So let's have a look at how we created this servant.
Please like and comment on the video below. That will allow me to produce better quality videos and more of them in the future. If you're interested in learning to trade successfully on sports, then why not visit the BetAngel Academy, where we have more detailed videos.
So let's go in and create a servant. And because we want to do an offset by one tick, you have to think through the process of exactly what you're going to do and how you're going to do it. So if I create a new rules file on the servant, that will bring up a blank editor. And basically, we're going to have to. There's so much depth that you could do pretty much anything. So we're going to do something really simple that will allow you to build and make it more complex according to your needs. But you can do pretty much anything. But we're going to keep it simple for you. Be aware, I've done this in practice mode. You should do too, because if you're using automation, you don't want it to go mad and wipe out your bank. So it's better to do it in practice mode, refine, test, make sure it's working the way that you expect before you unleash it on the markets. So what I'm going to do here is this rule is going to do a bit of scalping for us. But what we're going to do is we're going to be looking for the price to be coming in. So the first, if we're looking for the price to come in, the first thing we need to do is to place a back bet. So this is why I'm calling this particular rule within this automation rules file, place a back bet. And we're going to say place a back bet. It's going to be always armed and it's going to trigger once, and there's no need for it to wait because it's only triggering once. But we need to tell it what we want it to do. We're going to place it custom ticks above the back price. So what we're saying here is if I go into the market, it's going to basically place a back bet one above wherever the current price is. So on Betfair, the back bet in this particular race is 7.8. If you want to back, it's going to place it at 8. You can see because we've reversed the odds display, it's going to be a little bit confusing if you're not used to this. But basically, what we're getting BetAngel to do via the servant is to place a back bet here. And if the price moves, then it will adjust it, but it will place it at the best available price on this side of the column. That's what we're doing here. I'm going to get it to do fill or kill bets, so we're going to hold it in the market for 600 seconds. And then, I mean, it's up to you if you want. I was just thinking, do we really want to do it for 600 seconds? But yeah, for the purposes of this demonstration, I will do it for 600, but you may want to modify that. Then what we're going to do is that is our opening position. If I show you what that does, we need to save this as well. So we'll call this something. I'm going to call it A1, so it appears at the top of the list that we've got. A1, my scalpy servant. And that will appear at the top of the list, which you'll see in a second. I'll just close this. And there it is there. And if I click anywhere, basically, in this particular market on any particular runner, you can see it places a back bet. So I don't actually have to go in. I don't have to waste time chasing the price up and down. I can just point it at a particular runner, and then it will place it at the best available price. So you can see it's done that immediately for us there. And I'll just exit that. And I'll do it again. And you can see it's done one for us there. I'll just exit that. But basically, wherever we click, it will place a back bet at the best available price within that market. Now, because we're very close to the start of this race, I'm just going to cancel these positions out. And we'll go into this race itself and probably expand what we're doing on the next race, because if this race goes off, we don't really want to be in the market when that happens. So let's switch to the next race and we'll continue what we're doing from here. But we've created the first part here, which is basically the ability to place a back bet. And we can focus on which runner we're interested in. We can look at the charts, look at the pictures, and then the servant will actually just place it at whatever price we are, regardless of wherever we sit on that ladder. We could sit right at the bottom and be clicking on the lay side at 4.6, and you can see it's placing a back bet. And that is because we're using a servant, and if I press the control key and left click, it will execute what the servant is designed to do, which is to place a back bet on this particular occasion. So when we looked at the previous servant, what we were doing is we were placing a back bet in the market, and that was it. But obviously, when you're trading, you need to place a closing bet into the market as well. So that's what we're going to do when we modify the servant now. So at the moment, all it does is place a back bet. We want it to place a lay bet, so let's go in and do that. If I go into the control area, bring up the servant that we're working on, and then edit that particular file. So you can see here it's got place a back bet. So what we need to do is get it to place a lay bet. So if I just copy that initial line that we have in the file there, and I'm going to say place a lay bet. I'm just doing this because it's slightly faster. Place a lay bet. Always armed, which is what we want. And we also want it to place custom ticks, but we want to say that this is now below the best market price. So previously it was going as high as it could on this line. We want it to go as low as it can on this line, so that's why I was saying one tick below. What I'm also going to do is not put fill or kill bets on, because this is saying the initial order's been matched. Let's place an order to close this particular trade. So if I apply that, then you can see what we've done is we're going to place a lay bet, always armed, below, one tick below the current market price for a fixed amount, and that's all that we're going to do. Now, if you wanted to place a lay bet, you could actually use global settings and do an offset bet and offset it by one tick. And that would work just as well, because then you just have to look at which selection you're going to actively work on. But the reason I'm doing it this way is to show you some of the power that you can get with servants. Servants will do pretty much anything that you want. And we're going to do a very simple implementation of it here to get you to sort of ease you into it. But they can do pretty much anything that you want, and you can apply many different rules to them and make them do some very clever things. But we'll get you started at the basics first. So what I need to do is apply a condition, because we don't want it to place a lay bet if the back bet hasn't been matched. That doesn't sort of make any sense. So in order to say to it, place the lay bet when the back bet has been matched, what we need to do is apply a condition to it. So if I go into here and apply a condition, what we're going to be doing is we're going to say the matched bets amount condition. So you can see here the total amount of your back bets is greater than the total amount of your lay bets plus zero. So it's basically saying, do you have more back bets in the market than you have lay bets, in which case your back bet must have been matched, and therefore this condition is met. So in order to get you to understand exactly what's going on here, let's put this rule into the market and see what happens. So if I go into this market, I just need to select which runner I'm interested in. I'm going to point it over here, press control, because if we look at the shortcut, control and left click is what we're doing here. Then you can see it places a back bet in the market. When that gets matched, which this will do in a second, then it places a lay bet. But can you see what it did there? Because the price didn't move down when the back bet got matched, it immediately scratched the order. So let's try it on the favorite here. Put it in at 149, and you can see again, so let's try again. But the reason that it's scratching it is because the price is consistently going against us, so it would be a bad trade. And as a consequence, really, you don't want to be in that trade for any length of time. So can you see the effect that this has in terms of the way that it's acting within the market? So now the price has come back up to meet us at 151. See if we can get matched on this. Come on. Somebody took a slug of money and it's just dumped the position back in the into the market. So this is saving us from having a trade that is negative. It's immediately putting the order back into the market at a level at which it will dump the trade. So we can pepper the market with orders, and if the position goes one against us, then it will automatically put that position put the closing position in a place where we will not lose money. And we can repeat the trade as many times as we like, with the advantage of knowing that if we pepper the market with orders, it's not going to be a major issue for us, because if the order looks like it's going to go against us, then it will just close that position out. So you can see that while this didn't get us into a profitable position, it stopped us from getting into a potentially loss-making position. And that's where doing something like this is very beneficial.